Yes, good evening friends. So now in front of me or in front of you, you are observing some objects here. So now you are going to understand certain concepts, basic concepts. Our physics, especially a science of measurements. So generally, when you are going to measure something, what you are going to get is very important. Let us take a book here. So this is a book having certain thickness and having certain breadth and length. So what do you call about the bottle? So bottle is of 1 liter water bottle, we used to say. So what is meant by 1 liter? Just imagine. Suppose let us take a pen. So this pen is in the area of cross section. If you observe, it is circular here. So now when you touch it, what you are going to get, you are going to measure the diameter. Instead of thickness, we call it as a diameter. So now pen also has certain length also. So now when you are taking a remote, so you are going to get certain length and breadth, and when you hold it, you are going to observe certain thickness. So these are all come under our measurements. So when you are measuring something, what you are going to get? And the question is, which one is a measurable quantity? That we have to see. So any quantity which is measurable is called a physical quantity. Any quantity which can be measurable is called a physical quantity. So now, suppose if you are giving to any student or any child, they will say that it consists of 1 liter of water. So it is having certain thickness, a pen is having certain length, and the notebook consists of certain pages, and because of that number of pages, it is holding certain thickness. So now the question is, when you are measuring, what you are going to get here? You are going to get a length of the book or breadth of the book, and the height is similar to here, thickness. Now if you are given a scale, the breadth will be almost, imagine. So the science also, a hypothetical concept you will get here, approximately it might be 10 centimeters. So now when you are measuring this one, it would be 15 centimeters. So the 15 centimeters, 10 centimeters are here length and breadth. So length and breadth both are similar to the length only. Here it will be thickness also similar to the length only. So a fundamental concept, a fundamental physical quantity you are getting here, length. Suppose you have taken this notebook and placed in the weighing machine or common balance. Then what you get? This is having certain, what you call, mass. So mass is also a fundamental physical quantity. So in the watch or clock, the time you are measuring is second. That is also a fundamental physical quantity. So length, mass, time are fundamental physical quantities. So to measure the fundamental physical quantities, you get a fundamental unit. Okay. Now, if anybody asks you, what is the area occupied by this book? So to measure that one, what do you want here? You want breadth and you want length. Multiply these two values, you will get the place, occupying place of the book. So multiplication of the length and breadth values gives you the area occupied by the book. So area is now a derived quantity. So fundamental quantities are those which are not going to depend on any other physical quantity. Whereas derived physical quantities are the quantities which are derived because of it is depending on fundamental physical quantities. For example, volume of the bottle. Can you measure the volume of the book here? Can you measure the volume of the book? To measure, we require three fundamental quantities similar to the length only. Length, breadth, and height. So the product of length, breadth, height gives the volume. So volume is a derived physical quantity. Okay. Now when you are measuring, you are used to say centimeter, meter, and foot. So the length measurement in centimeter comes under CGS system. CGS system of units. And if you measure in meter, it comes under MKS system of units. If you measure in the length of the pen in the a unit used, if it is foot, then it's called FPS system. So we are using a word called unit. Unit is a standard reference. So now the FPS system is also known as British system. CGS system is known as French system, and metric system is nothing but MKS system. Now we have another system of units called international system of units. Now generally length measured in FPS is foot, centimeter in CGS, meter in MKS. The mass of the quantity measured in pound, gram, kilogram. The unit of time is second in all the system of units. So in the next class we'll see the system of international system of units and what are other fundamental quantities we are going to get extra. We will see.